In this example, I will show you how linear programming, more specifically, integer linear programming can be used for routing types of problems. Let's begin. Morgan Trucking Company operates a special pickup and delivery service between Chicago and six other cities. When Morgan receives a request for service, it dispatches a truck from Chicago to the city requesting service as soon as possible, with both fast service and minimum travel costs as objectives for Morgan. It is very important that the dispatched truck takes the shortest route from Chicago to the specified city. Assume that the following network, not drawn to scale, with distances given in miles, represent the highway network for these problems. Find the shortest route distances from Chicago to node 6. A first look at this problem, especially the graph, appears to be quite daunting. This does not appear to be a standard linear programming problem we have worked on earlier. The trucking company is interested in finding an optimal path that allows the company to dispatch a truck from Chicago to node 6 as quickly as possible. This path is also known as a shortest path. How would we formulate this problem as a decision-making problem? Clearly, this is a decision-making problem under certainty, because we have the exact distance between all pairs of nodes. For example, from Chicago node 1 to node 3 is 30 miles. From node 7 to node 6 is 5 miles. Other than that, we also know that the origin of this path should be at Chicago and the destination of this path should be at node 6. Let's try to define a set of decision variables first. The company wants to find an optimal path from Chicago to node 6. One possible path is from Chicago to 3 to 6. We are not sure whether this is the optimal path at this moment yet. An alternative path is from Chicago to 2 to 3, that's here, and then to 6. As you can see, a path includes a set of connected line segments. The first path includes line segments from 1 to 3, 3 to 6, and no other line segments. The second path includes line segments from 1 to 2, 2 to 3, and 3 to 6, and no other line segments. A generic path will consider all line segments in this graph. If the path includes a particular line segment, we will assign 1 to that segment. If the path does not include a line segment, we would assign 0 to that segment. That means we would have to consider all line segments. There are quite a few of them. I'm going to use x12 for the line segment 1 to 2. If the path passes through this line segment from 1 to 2, x12 would be 1. If the path does not pass through this line segment, x12 is going to be 0. As you can see, the axis only takes values of 1 or 0, so they are clearly binary variables. When we define them in Lingo, be sure to use @bin and end each line with a semicolon. It's also important to know that the line segments 2 and 3 and the line segments 3 and 2 are not the same. For example, a path could be from 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 6. Another path could be from 1 to 3, 3 to 2, 2 to 5, and then to 6. That's why we should consider line segment 2, 3 and line segment 3, 2 separately. Another interesting observation you may have noticed that is we don't consider any line segments that end at 1. This is because Chicago, node 1, is the origin of the path. If the path includes a line segment that ends with 1, that means after leaving Chicago, we come back to Chicago for a second time. This is definitely not going to be one of the shorter paths, so we can easily rule out this route. Similarly, we should not include any line segments that leave from node 6. Node 6 is the final destination. The optimal path should end at node 6. If a path leaves from 6, that means we would have to visit 6 twice. That's definitely not efficient. The objective of this problem is to minimize the total distance traveled. We do know the distance traveled for each line segment. For example, from Chicago to 2, the distance traveled is 35 miles. If this line segment 1-2 is included in the path, that means x12 is going to be 1, and the total distance traveled would increase by 35 multiplied by x12. Similarly, if line segment 2-3 is included in the path, we know that the total distance traveled would go up by 8 miles. That is, in fact, 8 times x23. We sum up all the x's with their respective distances. This is the total distance traveled. The optimization problem is to minimize the sum, so that's why I use mean in Lingo to do that. Let's take a look at the constraints here. At node 1, Chicago, we have to leave this node. There are three ways or segments that leave from Chicago: 1-2, 1-3, and 1-4. To leave Chicago, we have to make sure that one of x12, x13, and x14 should be 1. Using the conditional constraints we learned earlier, that would be the sum of x12, x13, and x14 to be 1. At node 2, first of all, I'm not sure whether the path needs to pass through node 2. Well, if the path indeed passes this node, we have to arrive at this node first, and then we also have to leave from this node. We can leave from this node 2 by 2-3, 2-5, and we can arrive at this node by 1-2, 3-2, and 5-2. If x1, x2, 3, and x2, 5 is 1, that means we leave from this node. We have to make sure that the sum of x12, x32, and x52 is also 1. If we don't pass through this node 2, that means x23 plus x525 is 0. We also need to make sure that x12, x32, and x52 is 0. Using the same logic, we can write one constraint for each node. We would be having a total of 7 constraints. Please pause the video here and examine all the constraints carefully. Here is the complete LINGO model. The optimal solution for this trucking company is to travel from Chicago to node 4, to node 7, and then to node 6. This path takes the shortest distance among all at only 40 miles traveling in total. Because this graph is not drawn to scale, it would be almost impossible to see this as the shortest path. I hope you found this example interesting. This also concludes this video.